Oh, hey. I didn't see you there. You caught me in the middle of perfecting my tennis game. You know, every time I'm out here, I find myself thinking about instantaneous velocity.
Dun-da-da-da-da! Calculus with Krista!
Today I'm going to tell you all about instantaneous velocity. What it is, how you find it, and its relationship to position and speed, velocity, and acceleration.
Given a function that models position or speed over time, so P of t or S of t, its derivative is a function that models velocity over time. So P prime of t or S prime of t is going to be equal to V of t. The derivative of the velocity function will be an equation that models acceleration, so V prime of t is equal to A of t. We can also say that acceleration is the second derivative of position or speed, so P double prime of t or S double prime of t.
Finding instantaneous velocity just means that we're plugging in a specific value for time t to find out what the velocity is at that particular instant. We can do the same thing with the position and acceleration functions to find position at a specific instant and instantaneous acceleration. To give you an example of how to work with these functions, if I hit a tennis ball like this, I can find an equation that models its position or speed over time.
This is the original function. If I want to know where the ball is, its position, 2 seconds after I hit it, I just plug t equals 2 into my position function, and this gives me its position at that moment. If I want to now find an equation that models the velocity of the tennis ball, I just take the derivative of my position function. Remember that we could call this function p prime of t or s prime of t, but since in practicality it models velocity, we'll just call the derivative v of t. This function will give me velocity at any time t that I want. So if I want to know velocity 2 seconds after I hit the ball, I just plug in t equals 2, and I get instantaneous velocity, or just velocity at that particular instant, 2 seconds after I hit the ball. If we want to find an equation that models the acceleration of the tennis ball, I just take the derivative of my velocity function, which is just the derivative of v of t or v prime of t, which we can call a of t instead, since it's just acceleration. This function will give me acceleration at any time, so if I want to know acceleration 2 seconds after I hit the ball, I just plug in t equals 2, and I get instantaneous acceleration, or just acceleration at that particular instant, 2 seconds after I hit the ball.
Keep in mind that you can relate these functions not just with derivatives, but also with integrals. So given a function for acceleration over time, you can integrate it to find a function for velocity over time, and then integrate that velocity function to find a function for speed or position over time. Well, you may not be able to beat me at tennis. I can definitely help you beat calculus. To get started, make sure you download your free copy of my Calculus Essentials ebook, which you can get your hands on by clicking the link down below, or this one.